I mean, if we go up some levels now, I might just... Oh, enemy surprises. I surprise you! I double surprised you. So maybe on our way back, I'll try that fork again. Maybe. Depends where we are. Let Jan and Rick take care of the squirrel. And the rest of us take on the big guy. Finish him off. Thank you. Hey, you're supposed to fight Jan and Rick. For that you shall perish. There's another one. He's just waiting there. Look at that. Pretty creepy, if you ask me. Boop. It's like he's guarding the place. That's what I hate, where you can't attack. Dead. Dead, dead, dead. Hey, you be hitting my dog. He's still working on his squirrel. Topping off, like I like to do. This way. More monstrays. There's a lot more traveling in this game, at least so far. It's like longer distance between towns. I can interrupt with her, but do I want to save it? Oh, jeez. Forte, I was about to say Aven. I don't think the dog can reach him. He'll heal himself. Oh, I thought he was gonna heal himself. Oh, Oh, McBain's healing him. Never mind. Knock. Who's there? It's a big ass bear, that's what. This way. Oh, jeez. Hold on, I want to heal up a little bit first. I know you want to fight me so badly. I will be there shortly. Because we got bashed around that last battle. Damn. I went through it. I'll run you through! Oops. This one's closer. Nice, 100. Maybe we line this up enough so she can get maybe all three. That'd be awesome. I love it. Sweet. That was my plan. I didn't do much to set it in motion, but once I saw them lined up like that, I'm like, we gotta do it. We gotta try. And we demolish them. I would not want to walk this in real life. Especially when you get attacked by boars, but still, even just the... Meh. I have fear of heights to the point where my fear could jeopardize me and make me trip and send me over the edge because I'm so nervous. It'll be like a self-defeating prophecy. Oh, come on. He ran right up to it. Pick an uneven here. I wonder how much further to this tavern? I can't see how they'd get much business. Unless it's from there's some settlements on the other side of all this. Okay. I think on the way back we're gonna try to avoid these things. Because I assume we have to run all the way back at some point. And that would be annoying. Cool. I thought he wouldn't be able to go. So McBain was going on and on about the destructive power of the water resonance stone. And really, it's just, it throws water balloons. Here we are. Wow. We made it. These people that are staying here, they probably never leave because they're like, well, it's such a long walk to anything. And we might be killed by boar or killer bears. Hilltop Tavern. Oh, Brazil is west, 400 milos. Maybe they get some traffic from Brazil then. It's pretty close. So I assume that's that way. Okay. Let's check out the outskirts. We can walk up here. Oh, there's a some kind of sign or something here. Una says, look, Forte, Grandpa Mac, it's Leon's monument. Forte says, in such a conspicuous place? I feel the same, says McBain. But it certainly is Leon's crest. Forte and his friends read the text engraved on the monument. The text engraved on Leon's monument says, in memory of my encounter with the pure-hearted bandits. Pure-hearted? What kind of bandits would have pure hearts? Okay. That's why I check the outsides of these structures, because sometimes there's stuff hidden on the side or in back. Can't progress any further there. I walked up here before. Okay. Oh, they have a weapon and item shop. Welcome. Would you like to have pickled Leon beans for your appetizer? Of course, we can't serve alcohol to children, though. Were they pickled in alcohol? Stuff. We got stuff. Exchange. Okay, so we have this stuff. We're gonna sell that extra twister bow. Suede armor. It's all the same stuff. Saving the other leather armor just in case. And I'm saving the stones just in case. Mick Jagger approves. Doll Knight 5! The girl with sky blue eyes. Okay. Bought. Oh, there's more than one copy. Well, we don't need more than one. Awesome. Not missing any books yet, and I hope to keep it that way. Yeah, probably after we talk to these guys, I'll stay. Schuber says, Forte! There you are. We were worried about you. Grandpa Raisin says, "Good for you! You friends came looking for you!" Schubert says, "Yes. Are the professors still mad?" "No," says Forte. "The principal explained the reason to other faculty members." Forte told him about the event in the principal's office. Says the grandpa.
"Did you hear that, Schubert? As I said, Forgeon does understand."
You know Principal Forgeon?" asked McBain. "My grandfather was the founder of the Kantus Music School."
"I retired already."
"He also met Leon in person."
"Hey now, Schubert. Well, it's a small story that happened a long time ago."
"Oh no, please," says McBain. "We'd love to hear that story."
"It's one of those long stories of an old man."
"Be our guest. When and where did you meet Leon, and how did it happen?"
"It was around 50 years ago. I just turned 30. We had poor crop year after year, and we were running out of food. We had eaten everything we had around here, and the only option left us was to go to another village and steal food. That was a stupid thought, I know. I got together with several young friends of mine and drew up a plan to attack travelers in Pensola or Letoratudo. We were that desperate."
"Oh, is that the monument outside the pure... Were you the... in the pure-hearted bandits?"
"Before we did anything, we caught one traveler."
"Caught a traveler?" says Forte. "Was that traveler Leon?" asks Una.
"Well, we had never set a foot out of Kantus. We needed someone who was familiar with the geography of places outside Kantus. We caught this traveler thinking that he would be a perfect candidate, and he turned out to be Leon. I put a knife to his chest and threatened to kill him unless he served as our guide. However, Leon was not shaken at all. On the contrary, he asked us to let him play his violin before we killed him. The man was asking for his last wish, so I untied him and let him play. He played his violin with great composure, as if nothing was happening. Of course, the knife was still pointed at him. The piece he played was heartrending, yet it had this warmth that reverberated throughout our bodies. Soon, I felt heaviness in my arm and didn't want to hold the knife any longer. Before long, everyone burst into tears. 'Don't cry,' I shouted. That was when I realized that my beard was soaked in my own tears."
"So you were crying too, Grandpa? You didn't really want to steal from other people."
"That is correct. Leon comforted us and offered us a handful of beans. The beans were from another country and would grow even under harsh conditions. Leon stayed for 3 months with us in Kantus and helped us grow the beans. The yield from the crop was very high. We were able to eat till we were full."
"So it's thanks to those beans that you're living happily now," says Forte.
"Not only the beans, my young friend."
"What else then?"
"Hard work was needed to grow the beans. Leon's violin gave us the willpower to toil on day after day. I had experienced the wonderful power of music. I asked Leon to teach me music, and I practiced hard in my spare time when I was not working in the fields. Before I knew it, my friends had joined us for practice, and we had a school of sorts that taught music."
Forte says, "So that's how the Kantus Music School was founded."
"Exactly. Leon taught us patiently and even wrote an etude for our practices."
"Leon's etude, right?" asks Una.
"Precisely. And once we were doing well enough on our own, he left us and went back to his travels."
"Wow," says Schubert. "He really was something. I wish I'll be a musician like Leon one day."
"You'll need to study music hard to do that."
"I can't wait to start practicing. I gotta run back to the school."
"Thank you," says McBain. "That was a very good story."
"You're welcome. I hope you'll stay good friends with Schuber.
I'm gonna study hard. I'll race you there.
I gotcha, says Forte.
Una says, hey, Forte, wait for me.
I'm glad we visited the other things first. We didn't rest, though.
McBain says, Mr. Raisin.
Oh, like raisin? Like a shriveled up brain.
Could I ask you about something?
Please, go ahead.
As you knew, Leon, I figured you might have heard about the resonance stones.
So you know about the resonance stones?
To tell you the truth, we are looking for them.
We hope to perform the water melody someday. I see. I do indeed have one of them in my possession, yet I cannot offer it to you. Leon entrusted me with it. It is important that I keep it.
I understand.
Leon insisted that I hand the stone only to someone righteous.
Hey, we're all righteous.
I'm not saying you're not righteous, but I don't believe Leon meant someone merely benevolent.
I understand. There must be a lot of meaning in his use of the word righteous. I wouldn't expect you to give it away unless you knew what Leon truly meant.
I can't give it to you, but I can certainly show it to you.
That would help, thank you.
I carry this with me all the time.
Grandpa Raisin took out the resonance stone from the inner pocket of his jacket.
Leon said that the phrase on this stone was life.
Always got the life stone. Okay, McBain, clobber him and grab it.
He's not gonna do that.
McBain memorized the phrase.
Life? That's not hard to memorize.
This is something to see. Thank you, Master Raisin. After McBain thanked him, Grandpa Raisin put the resonance stone back into his jacket.
I hope you'll be able to complete the water melody.
And we're back. Professor Musul says, Forte and the others haven't come back yet. Have they found Schuber?
Oh.
They ran all the way here. Over 1,000 miles.
You're late. The presentation concert is just about to start.
Really? I thought I had some time to practice, says Schuber.
You don't have time.
Please, quickly. Everyone get ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for waiting. We are now starting the presentation concert of the Kantus Music School. The first program is a piano solo by first grader Amity. Amity, please.
Oh no, it's the Swing Gang. A Swing Gang leader says, welcome to the concert, ladies and gentlemen. We are the Swing Gang.
It's them, says Forte.
Whoa. Oh, that's the, like, lapels or something. I thought the other four had, like, pigtails.
You, says the professor. Don't you even think about touching the students.
Shut up, teacher. Get lost.
Nasty.
Well, our purpose here is very simple. Principal, give us the school's treasure.
The school's treasure, says the principal.
We paid you a visit the other day while you were out, but we couldn't find it.
Right, so you were the thieves.
Thieves, please.
We just wanted to get the treasure without giving anyone trouble.
Call us considerate.
Since we couldn't find it then, we must ask the owner to give it to us personally.
This is a pretty funky tune.
Save your useless retort, says the principal.
Useless retort or not, we're here already.
We also brought this with us.
It's a boom.
If we throw this at the audience, bang.
Panicked voices. Run! They're yelling. Screaming. Don't move! Now that you know what we're capable of, just give me the school's treasure. Otherwise, I can't guarantee the lives of innocent people. I understand. Don't give it to him. No funny thought, alright? Not even one. Not even one funny thought. Well, that was quick. Here, take it. No, don't give it to them. If you get it to them, we have to get it back. Principal Forgin handed a box containing the musical score personally written by Leon. Okay, we have to get it back. Aha! Thank you. So long. Wait, says Schubert. Whoa! Did that just explode? It's just a shining ball, says Forte. Did it teleport them away? I guess so. Okay, the principal says, how are the students doing? Professor Vizea says, most of them have calmed down, but there's this one. Schubert says, let me go! I'm going to catch a swing gang myself! Hi, Forte. We're leaving at once. We must get back Leon's musical score. Hold on, Schubert, says the principal. Don't worry. I'll bring back the school treasure by all means. Schubert. I'm fine. I have quick feet. You know that, don't you, principal? The swing gang won't be able to catch me. Shut up, says the principal. Oops. Schubert. I'll give you a surprise test. What? Play Leon's Etude on that piano. You mean now? Why do I need to do that? Shut up and just play. Or do you want me to fail you? Fail? Of course not. Alright, I'll play. Where's Una and McBain? The principal says, how did you do it? Did you look at the score? What? No. Everything is in my head already. I don't need the score. Right. That's the point. A musical score is just a transcription of melodies onto paper. Once the piece is mastered, Leon's score fulfilled its mission. But it was written personally by Leon. It's the school's treasure. We have a more valuable treasure. Compared to this treasure, the musical score we already memorized is nothing but a piece of paper. The students. A more valuable treasure? Ish Uber. It's you, our students, says Professor Balza. Principal, says Schubert. The principal says, well, we'll organize another presentation concert. I look forward to your performances there. Practice hard. Schubert says, I'll go and practice. Forte says, the principal was cool. Una says, what he said really moved me. Forte says, but we certainly didn't expect this to happen. Oh, McBain is here. It may be a while before the presentation concert starts. Let's take a rest somewhere. Forte says, by the way, don't we have to look for the resonance stone, Grandpa? Right. Speaking of the resonance stone... Una says, so Raisin had the resonance stone. He won't let us have it, says Forte.
McBain says we can perform the water melody as long as we know the phrases engraved on all the resonance stones. Also, there's no confirmation that we are the righteous people Leon was referring to. Above all, for a reason, it's an important keepsake of Leon. We must concentrate on the presentation concert for now. If we're performing at the concert, we must give our best performance. It's about to start, says Una. Are you ready? McBain says.
Yeah!
Alright, so we're gonna talk to everybody again. Principal Fortune is organizing another presentation concert. It may have started already. Well, we hope not, because... We should probably go to the school auditorium now. The presentation concert is starting. Well, then how are you going to serve people drinks? I don't think we can rest if the presentation concert's going on. Otherwise, I would. The presentation concert is about to start. I hope nothing bad will happen this time. That's a great town. Yeah, he said that before. I don't know why I thought he might say something different for a second round. Alright, we don't need anything in here. I'm happy they could organize another presentation concert. The presentation concert is about to start. Go to the school auditorium. You're bossy. I don't see you going, you're just pacing around the room. I don't suppose... probably not. Let's just check. Same shield, armor, everything. Pretty simple so far with the weapons and armor. Now, did I visit everywhere outside the school? I think so. I don't think we talked to this person. Oh, that's Chad. Yeah, we talked to him. Did I talk to him? I did. Alright. So I saw her waiting over here. Let's check in here before we do this concert. This place is probably empty, though. Stomp, 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 stomp. Yeah. Empty, they're all over at the concert hall. Okay. I'm actually gonna go there next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode when we hopefully ace this contest. Although I want Schubert to actually win, so we'll see if that happens. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.